Apollo 9 launched on March 3, 1969 at 4 p.m. UTC from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center. Its goal was to test the lunar module in Earth orbit before a test in lunar orbit in Apollo 10, and then the lunar landing with Apollo 11. The crew would also test the command service module for 11 days. Because the Saturn 1B could not carry the command service module as well as the lunar module, this mission required the Saturn V rocket, even though the payloads would not be sent to the moon. The third stage of the Saturn V, the S-4B, used its substantial remaining propellant to boost itself into interplanetary space. The astronauts for this mission were Commander James McDivitt, Command Module Pilot David Scott, and Lunar Module Pilot Rusty Swigart. Swigart was the only rookie, as the other two had flown in space during the Gemini program. Because two different spacecraft were involved, the crew insisted that they get to give them call signs, essentially names, even though that had been forbidden by NASA management ever since Gus Grissom had named Gemini 3 Molly Brown. Ultimately, they named the CSM Gumdrop and the LEM Spider, and the two craft of subsequent Apollo missions would get names as well. After launch, the command module separated from the S-4B, flipped around, and docked with the lunar module for the first time. That first test complete, it pulled the lunar module away from the stage and, after some time, ignited the service module engine for a 5-second burn to show that nothing unexpected would happen to the combined spacecraft when doing so. Longer test burns followed on the second day in orbit, including with engine gimbling, and everything seemed to be alright. On day 3, they checked out the lunar module and used the descent engine to move the combined spacecraft, an ability that would later be used on Apollo 13. Swigart developed space sickness on day 3 to the point where he vomited. The US space program had not so far really encountered space sickness since prior missions didn't involve as much sudden reorientation as this mission did. The astronauts had to change their frame of reference every time they went back and forth between LEM and CSM, and they also had to test out their EVA suits, which required some maneuvering to get into. For later missions, crews avoided sudden motions when donning their suits. Swigart got over the sickness quickly, and they continued on with the plan, but the brief issue damaged his chances of going to space again. Swigart got to do a unique EVA on day 4, demonstrating that the crew could, in an emergency, exit the LEMS hatch and make their way to the command module hatch using handholds placed along the way. Because Swigart didn't actually transfer over this way though, Soyuz 4 and 5 remains the only mission where an external crew transfer was done. Finally, on the fifth day, the lunar module separated from the CSM with McDivitt and Swigart on board. They tested the descent module engine again and all the other systems except for the landing radar. They separated off the descent module and then, using just the ascent module, made their way back to the command module. The separation distance had been greater than 100 miles, so this rendezvous procedure was substantial. This had to be harrowing for everyone involved, since this was the first time astronauts were in a vehicle that could not bring them back down safely. The redocking went fine though, and the crew transferred back to the CSM. The ascent module was controlled remotely by mission control and fired its ascent engine until it was depleted of propellant. This put it in a high enough orbit that it would take 12 years for it to re-enter. After more days of testing the CSM, the crew returned on March 13th, completely successful, and NASA was ready to move on to Apollo 10. With that, thank you for watching this mission profile of Apollo 9.